After studying the position, origin, size, wall of the heart, the next one we are going to study about the chambers of the human heart. In case of human, heart is four chambered. How many chambers are present? There are four chambers are present. Now from these four chambers, two chambers are atria and two chambers are the ventricles. Okay, these two atria in which first right atria and second one is the left atria. Okay, from this four chamber, two chambers are called as atria, right atrium and left atrium, or in singular this is called as right atrium and left atrium, or these are also called as auricles. In these ventricles also these are right ventricle and left ventricle, means two atria, that is right and left, and two ventricles, right and left. Okay, now these atria, these are superior or uppermost chamber. These are the atria. This is right atrium, this is left atrium. Now these are the chambers which are present superiorly, and these are called as blood collecting chambers or blood receiving chambers. What it called as? Blood receiving. Because in this right atrium, impure blood is collected. In the left atrium, pure blood is collected. Okay? Means atria are two, that is right atrium and left atrium. These are superiormost chamber and these are blood receiving chamber. Okay? Now, these two ventricles, these are inferior or lowermost chamber. This is right ventricle, this is left ventricle. Now this right ventricle and left ventricle, these are lowermost chamber and these are blood distributing chamber. Means from these two chamber, blood goes away from the heart, from these two ventricles. And these atria, these are blood receiving chamber. Also these atrium, these are superior chamber. While the ventricles are, these are inferior chamber. These two are the ventricles and these two are the auricles. Okay. Now, these two atrium and these two ventricles, these are separated from each other by a groove. This groove is called as atrioventricular groove, or it is also called as coronary sulcus. What it called as? Coronary sulcus. These auricles and these ventricles, in between there is a groove. Externally we can observe this. This is called as atrioventricular groove, or it is also called as coronary sulcus. Now this coronary sulcus, in which coronary sinus open, and this coronary sinus opens means in this coronary sinus, coronary artery and coronary vein is present. These are the blood vessels of the heart. Okay. Now, these two ventricles also externally separated from each other, and this groove is called as interventricular groove. Okay, groove means the somewhat notch like structure, or it is observed as like the depression by which these ventricles are also separated externally. Okay, now see the four chambers, that is two atria and two ventricles. Two atria means right atrium and left atrium. Two ventricles means right ventricle and left ventricle. Now these two atria, these are superior chambers and these are blood receiving chamber. While these two ventricles, these are inferior chambers and these are blood distributing chambers. Now these two auricles and these two ventricles externally separated by the atrioventricular groove, or it is called as coronary sulcus. In this coronary sulcus, coronary sinus is open. Coronary sinus consists of coronary artery and coronary vein. Now these two ventricles also separated from by a groove. This groove is called as interventricular groove. Okay. Now, most important thing in case of the heart, if you remember this one, during describing structure or also during the describing working of the heart, you will never made mistake. Remember this point, very important, that is the right side of the heart. Remember, right side of the heart, it consists of impure blood. Which blood? Impure blood. And left side of the heart, it consists of pure blood. Okay, always remember, this side is right side and this side is left side. This right side chamber, see, the right side consists of impure blood means this right atrium, in this which blood is present? Impure blood. This right ventricle also consists of impure blood. Okay. This left atrium and left ventricle consist of pure blood. Okay. If you remember this point, then there will be no any mistake regarding describing any type, any structure or working of the heart. Which one? That is right side consists of impure blood and left side consists of pure blood. Okay. Now, just we observe these chambers. Now, important point is that you have to know about the blood vessels present in the heart. Okay. These are the chambers we studied. Okay. Now, in this chamber, whatever the blood vessels are present, you have to know clearly. See, the next one point. That is blood vessels of the heart. Okay. Now, first one, we studied that there are two atria, okay, and two ventricles. We individually observe these blood vessels and then we see in a combined figure. Okay. The atria are two, that is right atrium and left atrium. Okay. This is right atrium. This is left atrium. Okay. Now we are observing the blood vessels. In case of the right atrium, the blood vessel opens from uppermost side. This blood vessel is called as superior vena cava. What it called as? Superior vena cava. एंड फ्रॉम लोअर साइड ए ब्लड वेसल ओपन, दिस इज कॉल्ड एज इंफेरियर वेना कैवा. सुपेरियर वेना कैवा एंड इंफेरियर वेना कैवा. सुपेरियर वेना कैवा ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज पी कैवल एंड इंफेरियर वेना कैवा ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज पोस्ट कैवल. ओके, now these two blood vessels they collect the blood, means blood come from our head region which is impure and from lower body part blood comes here, these impure, means these are the two blood vessels which collect impure blood into the right atrium. And also coronary sulcus, that is coronary sinus, it also open in the chamber and collect the blood from the heart wall into this right atrium. That is now right atrium filled with the impure blood. Okay. Now, second one, this left atrium. In this left atrium, here we can observe the two blood vessels open. These two blood vessels are called as pulmonary veins. Which one? Pulmonary veins. These are two. And from here also the two pulmonary veins run from the back side and open into this right atrium, and here we can observe the opening as like this. Okay, that is in this right atrium four pulmonary veins opens and they collect pure blood. Which blood collect? Pure blood. Means these are also the blood vessels which carry pure blood into this chamber. This blood is pure blood. Now, this right atrium and left atrium. Right atrium consists of impure blood. Left atrium consists of pure blood. But these two blood never intermix with each other because here is a septum present. This septum, it is called as interatrial septum. Okay, this interatrial septum separate these two atria and prevent the mixing of the impure and pure blood. Okay, now these are the blood vessels. Now second one, the ventricles. Okay, what are ventricles? These ventricles are the lowermost chamber, that is inferior chambers, and these are the blood distributing chamber. What are these ventricles? These are blood distributing chambers. From this blood goes away from the heart, okay, as like this. Now these two ventricles, these are also internally separated with the help of a septum. This septum, it is called as interventricular septum. What it called as? Interventricular septum. Due to which there is no mixing of the impure and pure blood. Now this is right ventricle and this is left ventricle. This right ventricle consists of impure blood and this left ventricle consists of pure blood. Okay, now the blood vessels, from this right ventricle a blood vessel arises which is called as a blood vessel arises which is larger one and then it bifurcates into two. Okay, this is called as pulmonary aorta. What it called as? Pulmonary aorta. Now this pulmonary aorta, these branches, they goes to the lungs. Towards the two lungs, this impure blood goes for the purification. Okay, that is pulmonary aorta. And from this left ventricle, a larger blood vessel arises. This is called as aorta. What is this? This is called as aorta, or it is also called as systemic aorta. From this pure blood, it goes towards the body part. Where it goes? It goes towards the body part. That is, blood vessels from the right ventricle, the blood vessel arises, it is pulmonary aorta, it bifurcates and it goes towards the lungs. And from this left ventricle, a larger blood vessel arises, it is called as aorta. Okay. Now this pulmonary aorta and this systemic aorta, these two are joined with each other, and this joining structure, it is called as ligamentum arteriosus. What is it called as? Ligamentum arteriosus means pulmonary trunk and systemic aorta. These two are joined with each other with the help of ligamentum arteriosum, and it is the remnant of embryonic structure ductus arteriosus. Okay. Now in this point, just we see about the which are the blood vessels. Very simple. In right atrium, superior vena cava, inferior vena cava, and coronary sinus. In left atrium, four pairs of the pulmonary veins. In case of right ventricle, the pulmonary aorta arises, and from right ventricle, systemic aorta it arises. Pulmonary aorta and systemic aorta, these two are connected with each other with the help of ligamentum arteriosus. Okay. Now we studied about the chambers and the blood vessel. Now we combine this whole figure of the heart, and then we will study about these whole chambers and their blood vessels. See, the two uppermost chambers, that is atria, and lowermost chambers are ventricles. Always remember, when we draw the diagram of the human heart, always tilt it is towards the left side, that is apex is tilted. This tilting condition you have to denote in your diagram. Here also inter atrial septum, inter ventricular septum, both these are also, this is right atrium, this is left atrium, this is right ventricle, this is left ventricle. Okay. Now the blood vessels, here superior vena cava, it opens in this, and from the lower side the blood vessel, it also opened, this inferior vena cava. This is superior vena cava, this is inferior vena cava. This right side consists of impure blood, this right side also consists of impure blood. Now this left atrium, it consists of pure blood. Here also there is presence of the pure blood. In case of left atrium, two pairs of the pulmonary veins. These are pulmonary veins. Also from this side, these two veins run and they open into here. Here we can observe the opening of these two. Okay. In case of the right ventricle, the blood vessel arises, which is larger one. This blood vessel, it is called as pulmonary trunk. It is larger one, and then it bifurcates into two. As like this. This is called as pulmonary aorta. Okay. And from this chamber, a larger blood vessel arises. It turns here, crossing the pulmonary, and this is called as systemic aorta. Okay. Now, most important thing is that this systemic aorta, it is again showing such type of three blood vessels. Okay. Here we can observe also the three blood vessels. It is somewhat larger as like this. Okay. Now these three blood vessels, here we can observe, suppose this is systemic aorta. Okay. And this systemic aorta, it shows three blood vessels as like this. Okay. This is branchiocephalic. Which one? Branchiocephalic. This is common carotid, and this is subclavian artery. Okay, these are the pure blood supplying blood vessels. Okay, this is the aorta. Because from this left ventricle, this aorta is arises. Okay, what is this? This is aorta. Okay, this aorta is divided into three branches. First one is called as ascending aorta. Second one is called as aortic arch. And third one is called as descending aorta. Okay. Now this aortic arch, it is divided into three. That is first one, branchiocephalic. Second one, common carotid. And third one, artery, is the subclavian artery. Okay. In this way, we studied about the external structure of the human heart. Now, in case of human heart, the most important things you have to remember, that is, position is mediastinum. Human heart is present in the mediastinum. Its origin is mesoderma. Then wall of the heart consists of three layers, that is epicardium, myocardium and endocardium. Myocardium consists of cardiac muscles. Okay. In case of the chambers, four chambers are present, atria and ventricles. Two atria, that is right atria and left atria. Two ventricles also, that is right ventricle and left ventricle. Okay. Always remember, this side of the board or your notebook, it is written as right side. Which side? It is right side. Okay. And this side, it is always denoted as the left side. How it is denoted? It is denoted as the left side. Okay. Always one thing remember, this right side consists of impure blood and this left side consists of pure blood. Impure blood means deoxygenated blood and pure blood means oxygenated blood. Okay. Now, in case of these chambers, these atria, it consists of the blood vessel. In case of right atrium, superior vena cava, inferior vena cava. In case of left atrium, four pairs of the pulmonary veins. In case of right, pulmonary aorta. In case of left ventricle, that is systemic aorta. Okay. And this systemic aorta is divided into ascending aorta, aortic arch and descending aorta. And again this aortic aorta, it is divided into branchiocephalic, common carotid and subclavian artery. Okay. These are diagrammatical. Okay. Now if you want टू समराइज दीज ब्लड वेसल्स और इन सिंपल मैनर हाउ वी कैन रिमेंबर दीज ब्लड वेसल्स इजीली. इन द डायग्राम वी कैन ड्रॉ वेरी स्पेसिफिकली बट हाउ वी कैन रिमेंबर वेरी इजीली सी द ब्लड वेसल्स. इट इज वेरी सिंपल इफ यू रिमेंबर दिस शॉर्ट नोट और माइक्रो नोट. टेक द फर्स्ट चेंबर दैट इज राइट एट्रियम. विच चेंबर? राइट एट्रियम. From this chamber, the blood vessels in which blood is collected means the superior vena cava, inferior vena cava and coronary sinus. These blood vessels, these came into this right atrium. They came towards this chamber. Hence, I denote the arrow towards the right atrium. Then second one, left atrium. Okay. In this left atrium, how many blood vessels we observe? We observe 4 pulmonary veins. These are also came into this left atrium and both these collect the pure blood. Okay. Here is collection of pure blood. Here is the collection of impure blood. Means these two chambers are the blood collecting chamber. Okay. Next one. That is right ventricle. Now from this right ventricle, this pulmonary aorta, it goes outside. Hence, we denote this arrow as like this, which is the blood vessel pulmonary aorta. Okay. Then second one, left ventricle, that is from this also systemic aorta, it leaves the heart. Okay. In this way, if you remember these 4 points, we can easily understood the blood vessels which arises from the chamber or which come into the chamber. And always remember one thing, that is right side of the heart. It consists of impure blood and left side of the heart, it consists of pure blood. Okay. If you remember all these points very perfectly with the help of micro notes, then there will be no any mistake regarding the external structure of the human heart.